Today I want to talk about the art of the law and how that art got my guy from a DUI to a withhold on a reckless driving. That's up next. Hypothetically speaking, of course, I have a client who pulled in the parking lot of a gas station after leaving a adult establishment, a nudie bar. When he pulls in the parking lot, he squeals his tires. There's a cop in the parking lot. The cop comes out and doesn't stop him right away, but starts a conversation of like, why are you driving like a jerk? The cop lets my guy go into the gas station. Some conversation continues as they're walking towards the gas station, but it's not a formal detention. So then the cop leaves him alone, but steps outside to call for backup. And they eventually tell him to get out of the gas station, and they arrest him for resisting without violence and also DUI. So during the arrest process, a lot of MFers thrown around, and just doesn't sound good for my client, audio recording, not a video recording. He sounds really drunk. They got him dead to rights, it seems to be. But I found an angle there to attack. I'm not gonna know the details of that angle right now because it's legal caveat that isn't really going to be used very much. But nonetheless, I had a fight to fight. So I filed my motion to suppress, and the goal of this motion, it wouldn't get the whole case thrown out, but I was trying to suppress a decent chunk of their evidence so they'd have a difficult time in trial. But even if I get this evidence suppressed, or even if I were to win the motion and get the evidence suppressed, then I would think that the jury would still find my client guilty based upon the evidence that was still available to them. Now, with that being said, today we go to the motion. It's set for this morning, hypothetically. We get there and there's a problem. There was a problem that the officers didn't get properly subpoenaed. The prosecutor says, well, listen, we can either work this thing out right now or we can continue this. I'm sure the judge will grant me a continuance. That gave me the negotiation room to get it worked out, a very favorable offer for my guy. Went from a DUI charge to a wet reckless with a withhold of adjudication. Now, the withhold of adjudication is critical here because if you're adjudicated guilty and it's mandatory adjudication on a DUI, you cannot get a withhold of adjudication on a DUI. But if you're adjudicated guilty of any offense, you cannot have your record sealed or expunged. And you can't have any record. Once you're adjudicated guilty of one offense, you can no longer have your record sealed or expunged. This is my guy's first offense. With that offer, he is now going to be legally, he's going to be able to legally deny that he was arrested for DUI or ever charged with reckless driving once this record does get actually sealed. And that's huge for employment purposes, the fact that he can deny this. So, got out of the DUI charge with reckless driving. He's going to have about $1,000 in fines to pay, a little bit over that with all the court costs, all the crap like that. No driver's license suspension, has to take a DUI school, and that's about it. He's got to do 12 months probation. We can terminate the probation after 6 months. I think that's $45, and in this particular county, it's $45 a month for probation. So he's going to have a little bit of money to pay, but at the end of the day, the result of getting the record sealed is huge. So that's it, guys. Have a good one, and God bless.